गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन एंड वंस अगेन वेलकम टू योर हिस्ट्री क्लास चिल्ड्रेन. बिकॉज ऑफ योर सेकेंड प्री बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन फॉर सम टाइम आई वॉज नॉट सेंडिंग यू एनी वीडियो और यू कैन से दैट आई वॉज नॉट अपलोडिंग एनी वीडियो ऑन पोर्टल एंड द सेम टाइम आई वॉज नॉट गिविंग एनी PDF बिकॉज ऑफ दिस सेकेंड प्री बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन. बट नाउ सिंस योर सेकेंड प्री बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन इज ओवर so we will start again the same topic which we were studying before the start of the second pre-board examination. So if you remember children that we were studying one chapter nationalism in India and already many important topics of the chapter we have completed earlier only. So today I will start a new topic and the topic is the limits of civil disobedience movement. So children, I hope that you all know very well that what was the civil disobedience movement of Mahatma Gandhi. So today we are going to discuss this topic, the limits of civil disobedience movement. So see, in civil disobedience movement, most of the people of the Indian society, they supported Mahatma Gandhi, but still there were few groups and those groups did not give their support to Mahatma Gandhi, especially in this civil disobedience movement. Why they did not give their support? Or who were those groups which did not supported Mahatma Gandhi in the civil disobedience movement? We will see. So first group was of the Dalits and the second group was of the Muslims. So children, first of all we will discuss that why the Dalits did not support Mahatma Gandhi in the civil disobedience movement. So first of all, you should know that who are Dalit people. Dalit people are actually depressed people. They have no value, no respect in the society. Especially when the civil disobedience movement was started that time, the condition of Dalit was very, very miserable. They had no respect and value in the society and most of the time they were oppressed by the upper class Hindus. So Dalit people, they did not give their support in the civil disobedience movement of Mahatma Gandhi. But Mahatma Gandhi, he wanted the full support of the Dalit people. And it was a dream of Mahatma Gandhi that these Dalit people should work in tandem. They should be considered as part of the society. They should get respect by the upper caste Hindus. And for this purpose, he gave a new name to these Dalit people. And the new name which was given to these Dalit people by Mahatma Gandhi, that new name was Harijan. Mahatma Gandhi started calling them Harijan. And his main aim was that they should be part of the society. That's why this name was given. But there was a Dalit leader also, and that Dalit leader was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So already you know that B.R. Ambedkar played a very important role in making of our constitution. So Dr. B.R. Ambedkar united the Dalit people and formed one association which was known as Depressed Class Association. This association was formed in 1930 and under the leadership of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, this depressed class association demanded certain things from the Congress party, or you can say from Mahatma Gandhi. And the main demands were that the Dalit people should be given reservation and separate electorate. So these two were the main demands of the Dalit people, that they wanted reservation and separate electorate. So rest of the things I will tell you in next video. Thank you.